Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London and joining us to discuss his research on Poolbeg Pharma, it is Robin Davidson here today. Well, welcome. You're one of our proactive research analysts. And we've been reading your report this morning on this particular company because there's been deals coming in left, right and centre. Just this week, the CytoReason one that we've been looking at. So much going on, isn't there?
There is indeed, yes. So what Poolbeg has announced, actually came out yesterday, is an agreement with an Israeli artificial intelligence-led biotech company called CytoReason. And this is sort of interesting in itself. The company is going to be working together on a program to identify potential new drug candidates that Poolbeg can take forward in influenza. But it's actually also the second that Poolbeg has announced a similar type in the past sort of month or so. In fact, it's only really last month that Poolbeg announced an agreement with an American company called OneThree Biotech. And that was to look for compounds for respiratory syncytial in virus infections. So that's an infection that infects infants. And what is going on with both agreements is that they are making use of data that was generated from human challenge studies conducted by Open Orphan, which is, of course, the company from which Poolbeg was spun out last year. So what they've done is taken samples, I guess blood samples, that were kept in the refrigerator or freezer, in fact, from these studies, and they've sequenced the genes and they've sort of annotated it with over the course of the infection with the symptoms that the volunteers who were in these studies suffered. And this has generated a sort of a huge amount of data, and what they're using both of these companies for is to sort of sift through this and look for targets for drug development, and hopefully those targets will themselves lend itself to finding potential compounds that have probably been studied in other indications in the past. There's thousands of these compounds out there that they can bring forward and try to develop. So the idea is that by doing it in this way, they find a compound that's already got some human safety data that can be taken quickly into trials, and really they can shortcut the whole drug development process by bringing these compounds forward in areas where no one had ever thought that they may have an effect. So they're looking for data from both of these this year or early next. So it really could be very soon before we know whether they have found something that that can be brought forward and potentially developed in these two infections.
Mm. I'd imagine as an analyst, Robin, it's an interesting company to watch because there's never a dull moment.
Well, that's true. They have been very active, I think, in this area. I mean, the company's really only less than a year old, and they've already brought in two different products from universities that are in the preclinical stage. Potentially, these two new deals could bring in compounds, in the next year or so from that would be already for clinical development. And in fact, it follows the model which Poolbeg was really founded on, which was a compound that existed within Open Orphan and had been identified for influenza. That's called POLB001. And that one has already been in the clinic some sort of 10 years ago, but it's with another party, but it's going to enter or re-enter, if you like, clinical development under Poolbeg's stewardship later this year.
All right. Well, thank you very much. There's so much going on in your report as well. So we should say that if people do want to read it at their leisure, they can certainly do so by clicking on the eye in the corner of the screen, and we encourage them to do that. But for now, Robin, thank you very much indeed for presenting that to us, our proactive research analyst, that's Robin Davidson, here talking about Poolbeg Pharma today.
Thank you.